Hello and welcome to the 16th round of the Second Man on Fire Film Star Bash Tournament. I'm done with Wave 1 and claiming the final slot tonight are... Brother of Rock, obscure reference, it's Eddie Lee. And Brother of Blue Rule Follower 42, it's Red Rebel 24. So without further ado, let's get to it. And here we have it, Eddie Lee versus Red Rebel, a black belt versus a third Dan black belt for the final place in Wave 2. So one of these players will be the last player to get through to Wave 2. The stakes are pretty high and it seems like a relatively even match, both players being a black belt after all. Let's see what the openers are. Okay, so we have Eddie on the left here going for the kick opener that we've seen kind of, you know, throughout this thing. The kick opener is pretty standard throughout Tauri Bash, throughout... pretty much the entire tournament, to be honest. And Red Rebel here going for a defensive opener, keeping his feet on the ground. We've seen defensive openers play very well for those who want to do it. Okay, it looks like, I can't tell because of his skin. Yeah, that's a fracture on the left leg there for Eddie Lee, first fracture. Red Rebel still playing, yeah, defensively, keeping his feet on the ground, not really giving much in the way of an advantage here. I wouldn't say Eddie's off balance, but he's going to want to get that leg down. According to the real-time ghosts here, he does seem to be trying to do that. I'm under the impression now that I can trust these things. I can trust the ghosts. They're real time now, apparently, which is awesome, which is really good for predicting the outcome of stuff. So it looks like he is trying to get his legs onto the ground there, and I wonder if Rebel's going to be able to not get thrown into the air again, according to the ghosts. I'll leave it down to you guys for Wave 2, whether you want me to turn the ghosts on or off. I mean, I can always just toggle these things off. It's entirely up to you guys. I'll leave that down to you in the comments. I like the real-time ghosts, but they do kind of mess with the tension of the match a little bit. So leave me a comment on this video before Wave 2 goes live, whether you want me to do real-time ghosts or not, and I'll turn them on or off, depending on what you want. Okay, Red Rebel actually finally doing something a little bit aggressive. Oh, never mind. No, he's getting his leg out ready to step. I thought he was going for a kick, but I guess not. Eddie Lee here on the right, on the left with a disadvantage, but I wouldn't say that's unrecoverable. And in terms of points, they're both very, very, very close to. I imagine, yeah, I thought Red Rebel was going to go for the grab there, and he has. Okay, now it looks like Eddie's at a disadvantage. I'm not going to say he can't get out of this. His hand is still free, so he could try to catch himself and maybe even lift Red Rebel here out of the arena. I like this. It makes it a lot easier to tell who's who, because Red Rebel is red. It makes it really simple for me to keep track of who's who. Yeah, according to the ghost here, Eddie is going to try and put his hand down. Successfully does that, still at a disadvantage, but not down and out just yet. I mean, Red Rebel does appear to be going towards the edge of the arena, but I think he's probably anticipating that and is going to be, weird FPS drop there, is probably going to be anticipating that and trying to do something about it. Yeah, my FPS has dropped kind of low there. I'm not sure what that's all about. Maybe there's too many joints moved. I don't know. It'll sort itself out, I'm sure. And there we have it. Red Rebel wins. I got distracted by my frame right there. Yeah, it was a nice attempt by Eddie to stay in the game there, but Red Rebel was kind of on top of him for the entire time. 1-0 to Red Rebel, and we move on to our second mod. Now, much like the previous round, I actually don't know how this one's going to turn out. It really could go either way. I mean, both players put up a hell of a fight in the Aikido thing, with Red Rebel just taking it. Eddie put up a great defense. But as with Twin Swords, as the standard, it kind of comes down to the first turn. Eddie appears to be going for a slash. Nope. He's going for a slash. He's going for a cut. I won't be using that turn of phrase again. And for the third time in a row, we have no hits on the first turn, which is good. It means it doesn't come down to the first turn and it's not over immediately, which is really nice to see. Although it looks like Eddie here on the right, going for a much more aggressive opener, is just trying to get one hit down. Now, we've seen Twin Swords be over pretty quickly, and I'm hoping to see... Hopefully, we'll go into our third round for the... Oh, he just nips it! Wow! Okay, Red Rebel tried to get out of there, but Eddie just reaches, and on the final frame of that turn, manages to bifurcate him. That's a good hit. That's a very good hit right there. A lot of points going to Eddie there. And, That may actually be it. I can't see any body parts going out of the arena there, but it doesn't look like Red Rebel is going to be able to turn this back around. All Eddie really has to do now is not tap out. Now, Head doesn't tap out in Twin Swords? Question mark? I can never remember. No, I guess it doesn't. Yeah, I mean, I guess Red Rebel here could try and fling his body back into Eddie, but I don't think that's going to happen. I think this might, as with Twin Swords, and I've complained about this throughout the tournament. It can be over pretty quickly. Don't worry, we won't be doing Twin Swords again. I'll eliminate it from the tournament. But still, it's nice to see that this might go down to a three-round thing. Unless Red Rebel is able to flick back into Eddie. He appears to, right now, just be trying to stop his legs from going out. An admirable effort, which may actually work for him. At least it might prolong it a little bit. I mean, he has 0 points. It's not going to come down to points. That can't be his plan. He's probably just trying to flick kind of back over to Eddie. If he pulls this off, this will be like the most deserved win in Twin Swords ever. Well, I'm not holding out a lot of hope of that happening, to be honest, guys. I'm going to be totally frank with that. I can't see that happening. I don't think there's enough frames left. I don't think it's possible for Red Rebel here to sort of flick back into Eddie. But I admire that he is trying. I mean, God bless him, he is actually trying his damnedest to get over to Eddie there. He didn't give up as soon as he bifurcated. But it looks like that leg is probably going to tap him out before he can do any damage. Eddie are doing a kind of like pincer pose, I guess, trying to leap into the air. Probably the smarter thing that Eddie keeps moving here, just on the off chance. But no, there we have it. Eddie wins 1-1, and we go on to our third mod. I can't describe how happy I am that we've gone into our third round for the final spot in Wave 2. It's gonna be really interesting. 1-1 to each player, and this is a silly mod, so it really can go either way. I mean, 360 gold people, let's face it, it's not the most skill-based mod, so I really could see this going either way. Okay, first turn we have no dismembers and what looks like no fractures, which is probably for the best. I didn't want this to be over really quickly. We do have a grab, though, which is always good for a 360 mob that the players are grabbing. I imagine they're probably going to whip into each other any second now, as soon as both players lock. I guess both players really want that final slot in Wave 2. It's going to be a hell of a fight. Okay, we have one dismember. That is Red Rebel's leg off, and I think we have Eddie's hand as well come off. Now, I imagine Red Rebel may use that to his advantage, trying to throw the hand out of the arena there. Looks like Red Rebel's a little bit confused in the chat there. Lol, what indeed. I think the tactic here would be to throw the hand out of the arena to get the disqualification. It's kind of a race against time, actually, because that leg is on its way out. That'll be his death right there. That'll be the loss, unless he can throw that hand out. It comes down to this display of skill. Can Red Rebel throw Eddie Lee's hand out before Red Rebel's leg touches him out? Looks like he may have 2 turns to do this. Eddie is relatively safe, doesn't look like he's going anywhere. It comes down to the hand or the leg. What's it gonna be? He's still holding it. He hasn't let it go just yet. Okay, it'll be this final turn, because that leg is going out the next turn. Can he throw the hand into the ground to make it work? I don't know where this is going, guys. It'll come down to this final turn for the final slot in Wave 2. Okay, and oh wait, we have one more turn, but it is definitely happening in the next couple of frames. Where's the hand? The hand's right there. I guess Eddie Lee's grabbing with that hand, so he can't let it go. That actually probably was the smarter thing to do there. Yeah, I don't think there's a way Red Rebel can do this. And after the Aikido victory, what? Oh, there's... God damn it, there's no ring. There's no ring in 360 gold people. I fucking know this. I know there's no ring in 360 gold people. God damn it. I made that mistake last round as well. Okay, it'll come down to points, which is looking like Red Rebel actually has more points there. I think Red Rebel's gonna win this. Of course there's no disqualifications. I'm an idiot. Yeah, duh. Wow, I was creating tension there and I didn't even mean to. Red Rebel's winning by points. There's 2 more turns left. I actually think this is going to go to Red Rebel now. My bets are on Eddie after that, but if it comes down to points, Red Rebel's going to win and he's going to advance to the second wave. Wow, how could I think? It's the thing with the atmosphere that's confusing me, the red sort of ring in the middle there. Wow, my own little fuck up there. Yeah, one more turn. I think it's safe to say Red has this in the bag, judging by points, and after that Aikido victory, he probably fought very, very hard for it. I can't see anything else happening short of a bug, so let's just wait until we can call it. And there we have it. Red Rebel 24 wins in a harrowing victory that was made slightly more harrowing by my ineptitude to know the mod. Red Rebel 24 will claim the final spot in Wave 2, which is very exciting for me because that means I can finally start filming these things in bulk because I know who's in the actual tournament. I should say this now, on the off chance somebody drops out, because there was a couple of gaps, between the first batch of Wave 1 and the second batch. On the off chance somebody in Wave 2 drops out, their opponent will just advance. We can't replace somebody in wave two. That doesn't seem very fair because they won't have won the first round. So on the sad off chance that happens, I'm just going to prepare you guys now in case on the off chance it's the first round of wave two. I feel like I should talk about it now. That's our plan in case somebody in wave two drops out, is just to advance the next opponent. So yeah, thank you very much for watching wave one. I'll be back with wave two soon. If you have enjoyed this, please subscribe. I've been Jack Morris from Out of Five Films, and I'll see you soon. Bye, guys.